I already upload to new LMS. Okay, yeah. Okay. Okay. So previously we already talk about carbohydrate metabolism. Carbohydrate metabolism start from glucose. Yeah. Glucose. And then it will undergo a glycolysis. Glycolysis to be a pyruvate. Next, the pyruvate will be converted into acetyl-CoA. Acetyl-CoA. And the acetyl-CoA will enter the citric acid cycle. Citric acid cycle. Okay. Acetyl-CoA will enter the citric acid cycle to make CO2. And then ATP ATP and then NADH and also FADH2. Both of this compound will go to electron transport chain transfer. Chain reaction to make ATP plus H2O. Okay. ATP will be used as energy and H2O will be excreted in our urine. Okay. This is the main line of carbohydrate metabolism. But however, there is also a reverse reaction of gluconeogenesis. In here, gluconeogenesis. Gluconeogenesis. Why we have a gluconeogenesis? Because blood glucose come from blood. Yeah. So this is blood glucose. So in the case of blood glucose high, we will do the glycolysis. In the case of blood glucose low, we will have gluconeogenesis to supply glucose to be sent to the blood. And in the case of we consume many carbohydrate, many glucose, acetyl-CoA will also be converted into fat, fatty acid. So, fatty. Okay. Okay, this is important because fatty acid. And then fatty acid can be converted into fat as energy storage. Okay. This is the and as to supply pyruvate, to supply pyruvate, some of the citric acid cycle intermediate can be converted into pyruvate. Some of the cyclic acid intermediate, maybe I will draw the line from here. It can be converted into pyruvate. Okay. Okay. This is the outline of carbohydrate and fat metabolism. So where is protein metabolism lies? So in the case, there are two type of protein metabolism. First, the protein is come from our food. Second, the protein come from our body degradation. In a normal condition, protein do not degrade. Why? Because our cells need protein, so why should it degrade? Yes. Oh, in a normal condition, protein is not degrade. Protein will be degrade if we have a starvation, prolonged starvation. Then protein should be degrade because we don't have energy from fat or from carbohydrate. So in the case you eat a large amount of protein, protein also should be degrade because protein cannot be stored like carbohydrate can be stored in the form of glycogen. Lipid can be stored in the form of fat, yeah, but protein. Okay, so I will make this is protein, maybe not protein, amino acid. This is amino acid from diet. Acid from diet. Okay. So, for example, like you have amino acid from diet. In a normal condition, this amino acid will be used to make protein. In a normal condition, this amino acid will be used to make protein. So, for example, this amino acid will be sent to all of our body to make a new keratin in hair, to make a new collagen in our skin, to make new hemoglobin that flow in our blood. In that is in normal condition. In the case you eat excess amount of proteins, protein cannot be stored, amino acid cannot be stored. So in the case you eat large amount, then the excess amino acid will undergo degradation. And it will be split into two compound. Okay, so maybe I will put this excess consumption. Okay. So in the case of excess consumption, this amino acid will be split into two compounds. First one is so previously you have already studied that amino acid consists of four atoms, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. So the nitrogen will be cut from amino acid in the form of urea and NH3, and this is the carbon chain. Carbon chain, there are two type of carbon chain. First one is ketogenic. Ketogenic. And second one, what we call with glucogenic. Okay. Ketogenic amino acid then will be converted into acetyl-CoA. Glucogenic amino acid will enter the citric acid cycle or converted into pyruvate. Please pay attention. Please note that ketogenic amino acid will be converted into acetyl-CoA, but it will not enter the it will be converted in a normal condition. In a normal condition, for example, like when you eat excess amount of amino acid, this ketogenic amino acid will be converted into fat. This ketogenic amino acid will be converted into fat. So I will use a different color, blue color. Okay, I will use blue color. So consume excess amount of protein. Okay. So if you consume excess amount of protein, it's no use because protein do not store. By eating a large amount of protein, you will not expect that your muscle will grow bigger. No, it will be converted into fat. Yeah. And in the case you eat excess amount of protein, There are two types. Do you eat carbohydrate or do you not eat carbohydrate? In the case you eat carbohydrate, yeah, in the normal case, so for example, if you eat large amount of carbohydrate, you eat large amount of protein, yeah, and then consists excess amount of protein and carbohydrate, maybe. I will add here carbohydrate. Okay. So if you consume excess amount of protein and carbohydrate, how about the glucogenic amino acid? Yes, it also will be converted into acetyl-CoA and be converted into fat. But there are other condition. Yeah, in the case if you, I will use different color, green. I will use green color. Okay, consume excess amount of protein without carbohydrate. So in the case that someone consume large amount of protein but he or she do not eat carbohydrate, yeah, where the blood sugar will come? So the person will convert glucogenic amino acid into glucose. So here we will add an arrow. So the protein will be used to make glucose in the case someone consume protein without carbohydrate. Okay. So how about the next step? Okay, we not yet talk about this NH3, but how about in starvation? In starvation condition, so I will add here protein. In starvation condition, protein will be also digested. Protein will be digested, yeah. Okay. In starvation condition, protein will be digested to make also amino acid. Okay, in starvation condition, protein also will be digested. Okay, this is the starvation. Starvation. Protein will digest it to make amino acid. Okay. This amino acid also will be digested into NH3 and also carbon chain in starvation condition. Okay, as the amino acid will be converted into carbon chain, it will also split into ketogenic or glucogenic. The condition is same, a glucogenic will enter the ketogenic will be converted into acetyl-CoA, and in starvation condition, of course, we will not synthesis fat. We are starving. Why we synthesis fat? In starvation condition, all of the acetyl-CoA will go to citric acid cycle. So this is starvation. Okay, so in starvation condition, all of the acetyl-CoA will enter the citric acid cycle to make energy because we need large amount of energy in starvation condition. So, and some of the acetyl-CoA will release because normally when a starvation condition, the body metabolism also not so good, so it will be also the converted into ketone bodies. Okay, I already talked about ketone bodies at the last meeting when we talk about lipid, so I will not talk about this again. Anyway, you will understand that ketone bodies can be converted back into acetyl-CoA to make energy. or ketone bodies also will be released as acetone in the in our lung. So it will affect our breath. Acetone. Acetone and release in breath. Release in breath. Okay, acetone will be released in breath. Okay, I think I should. Okay. This is the ketogenic amino acid if in the case we have starvation. So how about the glucogenic amino acid? In the case of starvation, glucogenic amino acid also will be used to make glucose. Also will be used to make glucose because our blood glucose level should be maintained in a normal condition. So in the case of starvation, our blood glucose come from the degradation of body protein. This body protein. In the case of starvation, our glucose came from body. Also our energy also came from our protein. So starvation is not a good condition because it can lead to protein degradation. And if our protein degrade, we do not have enough hemoglobin. We cannot do, we will feel weak because we don't have hemoglobin to do respiration. And also we will become dizzy and difficult to think because the enzyme in our brain is degraded. So we cannot think properly. That's why malnutrition, starvation is a dangerous condition for the development of a nation. Yeah, that's why, for example, like African countries, many of African countries are very retarded because they do not have enough protein on their diet. Yeah, because their economy is not that good. So that's why many of the person experience lack amount of protein consumption. So this is the condition. Okay, next we will talk about how the fate of this ammonia. Ammonia will be converted, will enter what we call as urea cycle. And urea cycle will release urea. And urea will be released in urine. Kidney play a very important role in this reaction. Kidney play very important role. That's why if you or if someone experience a kidney failure, the urea cannot go out from his or her body, and that's very important aspect in protein metabolism. Okay, this is from kidney. Okay, yeah. Okay, this is the protein metabolism. Okay, and but urea cycle is exclusive only in mammals. Only in mammals. This is important for veterinary medicine. Later I will explain about fish and birds, but first you have to comprehend about urea cycle in mammals. Okay, this is the protein metabolism. Any question about protein metabolism? Please, if someone have question, you can screenshot the slide. Okay, if no question, I will continue to variation of protein degradation in various animals. Okay, so previously I already talked that protein will be degraded into amino acid. Okay, amino acid. And amino acid will be split. Will be split in the form of a carbon compound or carbon chain, carbon chain, and also ammonia, NH3. Okay. Okay, this NH3 molecules fate will be different from animals to animals. At least we know three types of ammonia metabolism in animals. So, first, ammonia extract freely as ammonia or converted into NH, fish, first in fish. Okay, in fishes. Okay, in fishes, there is a reaction NH3 plus H2O it will make NH4OH. This compound is a basic compound, NH4OH, and it dissolves freely in water. After the excretion, NH4OH will return back into NH3, and it will release into the free air. This compound release into the air. This compound will be released into the air, but NH4OH will accumulate in water in the case of bad circulation. For example, like you have a pond, you have aquarium with the bad circulation, you will have NH4OH accumulation. And this compound is a very basic compound. It will increase the pH of water in our aquarium or in our pond. And it will, the pH rise, fish will difficult to grow. And in a prolonged condition, they can be die. They can die. Next, NH3 is converted into urea. In urea, CO, NH3 two times. Urea, CO, NH3 two times. This reaction occur in mammals. Okay, in mammals, ammonia will be converted into urea. Urea will be excreted in urine. This compound will be excreted in urine. Okay, flow in blood and excreted in urine. Okay, that's why blood of mammals contain high amount of ammonia and urea. That's why mammals' blood is not a healthy food, even though in some culture, even in Indonesia, some people eat the blood of mammals. For example, like cow or goat, they take the blood. If they cut some animal, they take the blood and they will froze the blood. They will let it thicken and then they will fry the blood. It's not a healthy food because it contain a large amount of urea and also ammonia. And if we ate those food, we will have a urea increase in our blood, and that is not healthy. Nevertheless, moreover, some bacteria easily to grow in blood medium. So to eat blood is not a healthy culinary. So that is memo. Next, how about the birds? In birds, birds do not excrete urine. So you will never see bird pee. In birds, why birds do not pee? Because they don't excrete urea. They excrete uric acid. Yeah, uric acid. Uric acid is solid compound. So urea is a liquid compound. Urea dissolve in water. Uric acid do not. So uric acid is a solid compound, and in with it will excrete in the form of feces. Bird poo. bird feces. Yes. Okay, but what is the proper English for this? Bird. Stool. Bird stool. Yeah. Okay. I forget the English word. Bird stool. I cannot faces with stool. Yeah. Bird stool. Okay. This bird stool have important economic value because it contain high amount of nitrogen, can be used as fertilizer. Okay, this is the variation of similar with blood mammal. The blood in birds, chicken is also not healthy to be consumed because it contain large amount of uric acid. And as we know, as I say previously, uric acid, high amount of uric acid in your blood will lead to gout disease. Yes, so it's also not healthy. But different from fish, fish blood is okay. Aquatic animal blood is okay. Why? Because aquatic animal blood only contain ammonia, and ammonia is easily evaporated. So when we cook, we heat, we boil, even if we took the animal, the fish, the squid from the water and we cut them, the ammonia is released into the free air. That's why we smell strong smell from aquatic animal. That is ammonia smell. So the toxic in their blood already evaporate. It's safe. But in mammals or birds, the blood contain urea and uric acid. It do not evaporate easily. So that's why mammals and bird blood is not recommended to as food materials because it contain toxic and also probably it can easily contain bacteria and virus because a lot of pathogenic bacteria and virus can easily culture in blood medium. Okay, this is the variation of protein catabolism in various animals. Are there any question? No question? Okay, I will. Okay, you already. Please take a screenshot. If you see the recording, also no problem. Okay, this is the nucleic acid metabolism in animals. Yeah, various protein metabolism in animals. Okay, finally, we will come into the nucleic acid metabolism, catabolism. So in our diet or our body, mainly from diet, our diet contain nucleic acid from diet. Okay. Okay. Nucleic acid from diet can be in the form of DNA or RNA. So it will be degraded to make mononucleotide. So previously we already study in intestine. It will be converted into mononucleotide. Nucleotide. Okay, mononucleotide. And there are two forms of mononucleotide. First, we call purine, and second, we call pyrimidine. Purine and pyrimidine. Okay, I will talk first about pyrimidine because it's easily to explain. Pyrimidine will be split into two compound. First, the same with protein NH3, and second carbon chain. As for the carbon chain, it will be converted into urea, acetyl CoA. And you know previously that acetyl CoA can enter the glycolysis to make energy. To enter citric acid cycle to make energy. Okay. Whereas the NH3 will enter the urea cycle to make urea, in mammals. Okay. In birds, pyrimidine. How about animals? Yeah, actually for birds, fish, animal, metabolism is not complicated because mostly animal only eat certain kinds of foods. But human, we eat a wide variety of food. That's why the metabolism in human is very complex. But animal, different metabolism. Okay, so this is pyrimidine. How about the purine? Purine will be converted into uric acid. So human excrete to form uric acid. And uric acid will be excrete in urine. Okay. But what is important in here, uric acid accumulation in joints cause kidney cause gout. Okay, and accumulation in kidney cause kidney stone. Okay. Yeah, this is important aspect of purine catabolism. So purine will be degraded into uric acid and accumulation in joints cause gout. Yeah, it's very painful. And some severe condition can cause the person cannot even do simple walk. While accumulation in kidney will cause kidney stone, also not light disease. This is also a severe disease. Yeah, so both of this condition should be inhibited. Okay, those are finished about the nitrogen or protein metabolism. Yeah, so we study about total protein metabolism in the in our body. In condition of consume excess amount of protein, and in the case consume low amount of protein or in starvation condition, and also variation of protein degradation in animals, and finally about the nucleic acid degradation that will cause gout or also kidney stone. Okay, I will stop share. Okay. So we So I hope you will easily understand from the scheme that I already talked. Next, I will share screen about today's lecture. Okay. Yeah. Okay, this is protein metabolism. So yeah, this is what we expect you to know. Okay, this. Okay. So protein metabolism is different from carbohydrate and lipid metabolism. First, there are no nitrogen compound to be stored or mobilized when needed. For example, like we eat many carbohydrates, then we can store as glycogen. When we do not eat carbohydrate, the glycogen will be converted back into the glucose and provide glucose for our blood, provide glucose for making energy. Fat or lipid is also the same. If we eat large amount of lipid, lipid will be stored in the form of fat below our skin. And when we are fasting, lipid will be degraded to provide energy for our body. But protein, you cannot store protein. You eat large amount of protein, it will be converted into fat. Yeah, I already talked previously. Nitrogen loss while catabolism should be replaced from the diet. Okay. So, sir, if we don't degrade our protein, why should we eat protein every day? That is because in a normal condition, in a normal body metabolism condition, each day there are red blood cell that is degraded. Why? Our red blood cell has 120 days of lifetime. After 120 days, the red blood cell might be already contaminated by parasite, for example, by free radicals from our breath, for example, like we inhale some pollution from vehicle, from factory, the pollution enter our lung. In our lung, the pollution will be captured by our red blood cell. That's why our red blood cell should be destroyed after 120 days. And to regenerate the new red blood cell, we need protein. Yeah. So that's why we have to eat protein every day. And the other is also skin. Each day, 0.1 milligram, 0.1 gram, 0.1 gram or 100 milligrams of skin cell is released from our body. So each day, 100 milligram. Wow, that's small amount. Yes, that's small amount. But you think about that is every day. Every day. Yeah, but I don't see. Where's my skin cell? Yeah, you can see it. You can see the skin cell if you accumulate it. 100 milligram is not so many. But if you gather large enough people in a dance room, for example, like in movie theater, before COVID, of course, there are no distance. Yeah. In a movie theater, in a normal condition, you pack many people in a tight room, the skin cell will accumulate. So when the light goes off and the movie start and the projector start to send the picture, you can see in the light path, there is something that floating in the air. What's that? Dust? Yeah. No, the movie theater is a very closed environment. Yeah. It's inside the building. Where did dust come from? No, it's not dust. It's a skin cells. Skin cells of all the people in the movie theater. So if you took some object glass and you put Vaseline in the object glass and you swing it, yeah, you will gather a large amount of skin cell and you observe in microscope, yeah, you will see skin cells. Okay, so if you eat, for example, like ice cream inside movie theater, yeah, in the dance with the dance people, so there will be many people's skin cell will attach to your ice cream. Okay, that is skin cell. So many of our cell will die each day, daily. Hair also same. We cut our hair periodically, every week, maybe every month, and you need a new protein to make a new hair cells. So that's why we need protein every day. But we do not need excess amount of protein. We need just the right amount of protein. How many? Yeah, roughly about 1/3 of our food, yes, should contain protein. And if you are doing a high intense thinking, yeah, you need more protein, of course, because our brain cell is mostly composed of protein. Okay, next, nitrogen balance. Yeah, normal when nitrogen intake, same with nitrogen loss. Protein intake, same with protein loss. Positive when we eat more protein than we should. Yeah, that's why we will accumulate fat. Negative, we eat less nitrogen, less protein than that we lost. As for amino acid, we separate amino acid become two parts. There are essential amino acid and non-essential amino acid. There are 20 kinds of amino acid, and the one that is arginine, histidine, isoleucine, leucine, lysine, methionine, phenylalanine, threonine, tryptophan, and valine. These are all amino acid. However, if you see some book, you can see some slight different between essential and non-essential. This is because in children, we need 10 essential amino acid. But when we grow as an adult, we only need 8 essential amino acid. The other two we can synthesize from other essential amino acid. So in the case, if we do not eat non-essential, we can convert essential amino acid into non-essential amino acid. But if we don't eat protein at all, yeah, of course, we also cannot synthesize non-essential amino acid. So basically, yeah, we need protein every day, mostly the essential amino acid. Next, protein turnover. Okay, so protein is steadily degrade, as I said previously, and biosynthesized. So we are in balance, for example, like take an example as skin cells. Yeah. We, every day, our body synthesize new skin cells. However, our body each day release dead skin cells. If the synthesis too fast and the release too slow, then there is a condition known as what kind of syndrome? I forget the name of the syndrome. Yeah, so it's baby skin cell syndrome. So the cell will white but easily become rash if it gets sunlight and become very itchy. Yeah, if your skin cell synthesis is too fast. Skin cell synthesis is too low, and you will have a rapid aging. The aging will become faster. So this should be balanced. Release amino acid during protein turnover used to make protein. So the degraded amino acid, if it's still good, it will be used to make new protein. Protein life cycle are different. For example, like extracellular protein such as enzyme, antibody, and hormone, fast turnover. For example, like we have antibody. So for example, like we get a COVID vaccination, and then our body will make COVID antibody. But if this COVID antibody do not use for a certain time, then our body will not make it again. That's why we need a vaccine booster in order for to sensitize our white blood cell to synthesize new antibody. Okay. Yeah, and next, structural protein such as collagen, longer turnover. So like our skin cell, it's longer turnover. Yeah, the very long turnover will be enzyme in our heart cell. Yeah, our heart cells start to beat when we are still in our mother womb until now. And if it stop, yeah, then our time in the world is over. Yeah, so it's very long, very long turnover, our lifetime turnover, the enzyme in our liver, heart cell. Protein degradation is an important regulation in metabolisms. This is a nice table about short life enzyme like ornithine decarboxylase, etc. Long life enzyme like aldolase, DHPDH, etc. Okay, protein degradation. There are two pathway for protein degradation. First pathway, it involves lysosome organelle. Lysosome is an organelle in our cell which function as organelle that degrade the foreign bodies, for example, like virus, bacteria, or even food. Yeah, food enter our body and it will be ingest by our lysosome. Lysosome will digest virus, food, and other foreign material, include protein. Yeah. So that is lysosome. Next, ubiquitination. Ubiquitin is a protein which, if some protein attached by ubiquitin, it will become a target for the other protease. Yeah, the protease will cut off this protein and make smaller peptide and enter the amino acid pool. Next, amino acid pool. Amino acid in the body come from extra and intracellular protein degradation, mainly in starvation condition. Second, amino acid reabsorption from dietary protein. And last is de novo synthesis. What is de novo synthesis? De novo synthesis in human is the conversion from essential amino acid to make non-essential amino acid. That what we call de novo synthesis. So next, amino acid are used for protein synthesis. Yeah. Amino acid excess will go to catabolism. So this is summarize what we talk in the previous lecture and also today. Yeah, so from food and protein secretion, digestion, go to amino acid in intestine, absorption in the blood, go to amino acid pool, mainly in liver. Yeah. And also liver carried out de novo synthesis as required from phosphoenolpyruvate, phosphoglycerate, oxoacids, and also sugar phosphate. And excess amino acid will undergo catabolism or degradation. It's about 50 until 100 gram per day. The carbon chain will go to make glucose or lipid, ketone body, or also energy. Whereas the ammonia will be excreted in the form of urea through kidney. Yeah. Okay, next. Amino acid main catabolic pathway. So yeah, so amino acid main catabolic pathway, amino acid that is not used in protein synthesis will undergo a catabolic pathway. Will undergo a catabolic pathway, and the ammonia will excrete in the form of urea. Carbon chain will be convert into energy and making CO2 and water, and also can be make glucose to supply blood glucose to maintain blood glucose level, and then to make acetyl-CoA to make fat. So if we eat many protein, also it will be converted into fat. And also making ketone bodies that can be released from our breath. First step in amino acid catabolism is the release of alpha amine group. That can be done in two ways, transamination and also oxidative deamination. Okay, this is the transamination reaction. Yeah. Transamination, the terminology trans mean there is a move, there are move of amine group from one compound into another compound. In this case, from L amino acid, the amine group is transferred into alpha ketoglutarate to make L glutamate. and it leaves an alpha ketone group. Next, oxidative deamination. In oxidative deamination, there is an energy production from NAD plus to NADH that will release urea. This is the degradation process of amino acid. So amino acid, it will be used, it will use intermediate of glutamate. Okay, next, ammonia transport into the liver for urea synthesis. So urea synthesis only took place in two parts of our body, first in the liver and second in the kidney. Nevertheless, the amino acid can be found in all of our body. So this amino acid should be sent into the liver, mainly the liver. Yeah. Should be sent into the liver, and in the liver, yeah, in most tissue, the glutamate will be converted into glutamine. Yeah, so you will notice one addition of amine group, and glutamine will be sent into the liver. Yeah. In the liver, glutamine will be captured in urea cycle, and the excess ammonia will be converted into urea. This is the reaction in the liver. The other part, when we study about carbohydrate metabolism, also you will remember about Cori-alanine cycle. In Cori cycle, in alanine cycle, yeah, there is an alanine in which used to transfer carbohydrate, yeah, especially glucose, from liver to muscle, and returning back of muscle to liver will carry out alanine. This alanine will then release ammonia and also will be sent to the urea cycle. Urea cycle is a form of urea synthesis. This is important reaction in mammals because we cannot release free ammonia, and ammonia is very toxic in our blood. So that's why it should be converted into urea. So there are 5 steps in urea cycle. Urea and then transported to kidney via blood flow, filter, and extract. So so you see in here, this is urea cycle. It happened in combination between mitochondria and also cytoplasma with total reaction. Carbon dioxide plus 2, it actually should be, yeah, plus 2 nitrogen. First come from free ammonia, second come from aspartate contain 1 nitrogen. Finally, this aspartate will be converted into fumarate. The nitrogen will be released into urea. Urea contain 2 ammonia group. Next, ATP will be used for this reaction because this reaction using energy. 3 ATP will be used in which 2 ATP is produced, 2 ADP is produced, and 1 AMP is produced. So it's actually equivalent with 4 ATP. Okay, next, this is the 5 step in urea cycle. First, there is a molecule called carbamoyl phosphate in which will act as intermediate to bring the ammonia into the citric acid cycle. Carbamoyl phosphate will be converted into citrulline in mitochondria. Citrulline will be transferred outside mitochondria to cytosol, converted into arginosuccinate. Next, will release fumarate. This reaction will provide arginine. Arginine will release urea, and in which the urea cycle is finished. However, the arginine residue will converted into ornithine. Ornithine will be back to mitochondria and make a reaction with carbamoyl phosphate. Yeah, anyway, the output of this reaction is urea and fumarate. Fumarate is then enter Krebs cycle or citric acid cycle. Okay, so urea cycle and citric acid cycle has a correlation. Which citric acid cycle only occur in mitochondrial matrix, whereas urea cycle, also half of the urea cycle occur in mitochondrial matrix and half of its cycle occur in cytosol, and both of these cycle are found by Hans Krebs. So urea cycle also often to be called with Krebs cycle, and sometimes it's confusing. So we usually name this urea cycle, and for citric acid cycle, it's Krebs cycle. Okay, so you will see in here that the fumarate will be circulate again to citric acid cycle and go to urea cycle and release again. Yeah, so it actually make a larger cycle that is connecting urea cycle and also citric acid cycle. Okay, how about the amino acid catabolism? So we have to split this amino acid catabolism into two main category. First is glucogenic amino acid. This glucogenic amino acid is an amino acid that can be converted into glucose, as I stated previously. It contains all of the amino acid unless amino acid that can be converted into acetyl-CoA. So this is only acetyl-CoA or acetoacetate. Yeah, so pyruvate, ketoglutarate, succinyl-CoA, or other citric acid cycle intermediate is glucogenic amino acid. Only ketoglutarate, only acetyl-CoA is ketogenic amino acid. So you will see this blue box is ketogenic amino acid and orange box is glucogenic amino acid. So if you have to choose, which one is better, glucogenic amino acid or ketogenic amino acid? So glucogenic amino acid is more useful than ketogenic amino acid because glucogenic amino acid will be converted into glucose and we can convert glucose back into acetyl-CoA or energy. However, we cannot convert acetyl-CoA or acetoacetyl-CoA to make glucose. We cannot. These two molecule only can be converted into ketone bodies or to make fat, body fat. So you will now see, so you will now can read the ingredients in a protein product. Yeah? If you read, then you will choose glucogenic amino acid over ketogenic amino acid. That is the recommendation. Of course, essential amino acid is better than non-essential amino acid. Okay, I will skip this. Okay. Genetic disorder in amino acid catabolism. There are several disorder in amino acid catabolism. First is albinism. Okay. Albinism is known for their white skin and blonde hair, even though they came from non-Caucasus race. For example, like Malay race, yeah, normally Malay people will have a dark hair color and also brown skin. But in albinism condition, it will also have a white skin and blonde hair. Albinism can happen not only in human but also in animals. So we'll have for example like albinism horse, albinism cat, and other species. Okay, so why this happen? Because the defective process in melanin synthesis. So we synthesize melanin from tyrosine is an amino acid. It will be converted in our skin to melanin. Melanin is pigments, skin pigment. Lack of pigmentation will cause white hair and pink skin. So the important enzyme is tyrosinase. But normal people will want to inhibit tyrosinase because by inhibit tyrosinase, we will have a white skin. Yeah, this can this lead to the research of various cosmetics, especially skin whitening, which contain tyrosinase inhibitor. Yeah. I also have several research about this tyrosinase inhibitor. Next, alkaptonuria. This is because the defect in tyrosine degradation. It will have a dark pigment in urine, lead developing arthritis. So this is, as for albinism, it's not a lethal condition, but for alkaptonuria can lead to lethal condition. Argininemia, problem in urea synthesis, so it will have a mental retardation. Arginosuccinic acidemia, it will cause a drop in blood pH, and it will cause vomiting, convulsion because we have low pH. The same if you have a gastric ulcer, yeah, you have a gastric ulcer, your pH also will be decreased. That's why you will be vomiting. You will feel not comfortable in your stomach. That's because the drop of pH. Carbamoyl phosphate synthase 1 deficiency. Yeah, it will cause lethargy, convulsion, and early death. Homocystinuria. Okay, homocystinuria is important disease because it's life expectancy is high. Yeah, homocystinuria life expectancy high. So unlike the carbamoyl phosphate deficiency, life expectancy is low. Homocystinuria life expectancy is high, but life quality is low. So that's why this become a problem. Why life quality is low? Because fault bone development. So it will have a weak bone. And then mental retardation. It's difficult to live with mental retardation. Next, maple syrup urine disease. Yeah. With the problem of brain chain alpha keto acid dehydrogenase complex deficiency. And it will cause vomiting, convulsion, mental retardation, and early death. Methylmalonic acidemia. Okay, this is because of methylmalonyl CoA mutase and causing also early death. Phenylketonuria. Phenylketonuria is a common disease with the approximate incidence less than 8% per 100,000 births. But, however, this is from the book 2017. I think this is the data from 2008. Yeah. The data came from 2008. And now, the individual live with phenylketonuria is increasing. So in some food product, you can see that it will have a warning it that say contain phenylalanin. Should be used with careful with person with ketonuria. Especially with an expectant mother with phenylketonuria, it's dangerous if consume phenylalanin. So it will cause neonatal vomiting and also mental retardation in children. But if we can stop the phenylalanin consumption, then phenylketonuria is no problem. So people with phenylketonuria should not eat something with phenylalanin. And there are so many food or protein contain phenylalanin. So it's quite difficult to avoid something with phenylalanin. Okay, this is amino acid biosynthesis pathway. Please study about this. Okay, amino acid. In human, we just take it for granted from our food source. But who made the amino acid in nature? Plant. Yeah, plant make amino acid by fixing atmospheric nitrogen. This atmospheric nitrogen will be fixed in plant with the help of bacteria, such as Acetobacter, Nitrobacter, Rhizobacterium, and other bacteria. And ammonia will be converted into organic nitrogen compound such as amino acid with the help of various enzymes. nitrogen fixation, nitrogen uptake from biosphere occur with the help of Acetobacter, Cyanobacteria, Rhizobium, and other symbionts. Okay, this is some learning check. You can study about this later. You can try to answer this question. Okay, those are all the materials about the protein metabolism. So please read again. I will stop the recording.